Clive!
Enough of this! What? She's gone.
What's happening?
Give her back. Give her back. Give her back.
My lady.
Where is she? Where is Garuda? What have you done to me? What have you done?
Look at me, my lady. We need you here. What the hell is going on?
You took it from her. How'd you do that? Fuck me. I hope the bear has found a way out. Clive, this place is ready to collapse, and I'd rather not be here when it does. If your dominant started this fire, and I'm betting he did, he'll be long gone.
Damn it all.
What was that?
I created a diversion as commanded, Your Grace. The villagers escaped in the confusion. As should we.
Yes.
Oh, look. Morning has broken. And here come the cavalry, itching to butcher the bastards who made them miss their morning gruel. Come on. If they catch us leaving a burning care, people might jump to conclusions.
Right.
Benedicta said you'd taken her power. You don't still have it, do you?
I think I do. I can feel it.
Stop there! Where did you two come from?
Well, are you keen to try it? What could possibly go wrong?
Yeah.
You there! A moment!
Oh, it's only me!
Dummy gaff, are you trying to get yourself killed?
It's not me who's been playing with fire. You don't do things by halves, do you? This way. So if it wasn't you or him who freed the bears, who was it?
Good question. Someone who didn't have their hands full fighting a bloody harpy, I guess. But what matters is they're safe. Something they wouldn't be had it not been for you, Gav.
Just doing me job, like. So, what about his dominant?
Gone. And after we were so close.
Well, I can track him.
Why would you?
Sid told us about your family. Lost me own to Imperial Steel. Sometimes vengeance is the only thing that keeps you going.
Thank you.
Go safely, brothers.
I reckon he liked you.
She's gone.
My lady, you have to hold on. I'm going to get you.
Gone. What am I going to do? The Barnabas.
How long to the coastal road?
At this pace, we won't make it by sunset.
He'll know. He'll cast me out like all the others. What am I going to do?
My lady.
Carol.
What do we have here?
Fetch a good price, I reckon.
But we'd be doing the slavers a disservice if we didn't appraise her worth.
Stay away!
It's all right. They can't hurt you anymore. Come on. Let's go home.
Is this it, Adolphus? My punishment for not listening to you?
Sid.
Do you feel it too?
Garuda.
By the flames.
much ether. She can't control it. If Garuda isn't stopped, that vortex will swallow this whole forest, and us along with it.
And I'll stop her.
You'll stop her.
I heard it again. Someone is calling me.
Damn it, lad. That doesn't mean you have to listen. Well, I should have gone with Gav. Clive, I don't think you understand. That's not just windy weather you're wandering into. Benedicta's rage knows no bounds. And that's on a good day. I don't want to know what's waiting inside that.
But I do. I have to find out. And I'm not turning back. There are so many.
Aye. One for every fragment of us.
Yeah! Ugh! boy.
Look what the curl dragged in.
If you're gonna buy something, be quick about it. It'd better all be here. You're rubbing me blind, you know. It'd better all be here. You're rubbing me blind, you know. It'd better all be here. I'll be thankful you got that much. You got out else? I reckon I can find a buyer. You got out else?
Well? What do you want? It'll last you a good while. No scratches, right? Not bad, if I do say so myself.
See, I'm busy here.
But I ain't the cook, am I? Look. You got anything needs repairing? Yeah, another time.
Escape their masters in the Imperial capital.
We'll be needing more wood. But if I step away to fetch any, this lot will be down around our ears.
Ah, you there. Perfect timing. I couldn't persuade you to fetch me some timber, could I?
I'd be happy to.
Oh, thank you. You'll be helping me and the hideaway both. Takes a lot of work to keep this place standing. More than we can manage, if I'm honest.
It certainly looks like you've got your hands full.
Ah, you can say that again. The Fallen knew their craft, make no mistake, but not even their handiwork lasts forever. That's why the walls need shoring up. Can't have the vegetable patch crushed before our first harvest now, can we?
No, I suppose not. All right, where can I find this wood?
Ask over at the White Ads. They'll point you in the right direction. Thanks again. I really appreciate the help.
Do you think we should go and help?
Don't think I haven't noticed you stealing sips from that pot.
Sid can take some getting used to. But his heart's in the right place. Give him a chance.
If you can read, don't let Otto know. We'll put you to work on the ledgers too.
Ah, a new face. And, dare I hope, a willing pair of hands. The fat Chocobo is a demanding mistress, and we are too few to keep her on her feet. Might I persuade you to deliver a meal or two to souls in need of sustenance? For your trouble, I can offer you the contents of my strongbox and my enduring gratitude.
I don't see why not.
Marvelous. And who exactly do I have the honor of addressing?
Clive.
Delighted to make your acquaintance, Clive. I'm Kenneth, and mine are the weary shoulders upon which the weight of this fine establishment rests. Now, I have three hungry customers awaiting their victuals. Take these if you would, and be careful. They're hot.
Food.
I was hoping it might be. Well, doesn't this look fine? Thank you, lad. You're new, aren't you? Kenneth's running you ragged already, I expect, the old rascal.
Well, he did say he'd give me something for my trouble.
And so he should. We're not slaves anymore. Well met, lad, and keep up the good work.
Oh, my thanks. I hope you do not think me lazy for waiting to be served like a lord. Only my former master did not use me kindly, you see. He left me half lame, truth be told. But Sid took me in nonetheless. Well, the hideaway is the home I never knew, and a mighty fine one at that.
Excuse me. The man working over by the garden sent me to fetch some wood.
Ah, that'll be Geoffrey, Master Carpenter. Luck would have it, we've just finished cutting the timber he's after. You take as much as you need from the stack.
Thank you.
No, not at all. We appreciate the assistance.
Better get this to Geoffrey, was it?
Oh, you're back. Hope fetching that wood wasn't too much trouble.
Will this be enough?
This will do nicely, thank you. With a bit of luck, the walls won't be falling in on us just yet.
That sounds ominous.
Oh, it's not as bad as all that. And it's a damn sight better than the alternative. We're safe, we're warm, and we're hidden. What more could we ask for? Now stop fretting and take this. You've earned it. Welcome to the fold.
There's no need to...
That's not a matter of need, my friend. You're one of us now.
So much more to farming than just seeds and soil.
Your food.
Just a moment. I need to finish this. I won't be a burden. I'm of no use to anyone as I am, but maybe if I can master this.
All right, but see that you eat it before it gets cold.
Of course. Thank you.
That's the last one, eh? I'd better let Kenneth know.
Yours is not a familiar face. Are you new to the hideaway, perchance?
You could say that.
Well then, allow me to welcome you. I am Harpocrates II Hyperboreus.
That's,
quite a mouthful, I know. Which is why everyone here has taken to calling me simply Tomes. On account of the company I keep. And what varied company. I'm a collector, you see. Not of bijou and baubles, but of stories. The history and culture of these isles have ever been a source of endless fascination to me. But alas, my days of wandering the realm in search of new tales are far behind me. And so I've taken to sharing that which I've gathered with all who might listen. Perhaps you would care to listen. I have a few new notes that might interest you. I have compiled some new entries, if you would like to see them. I have quite the find for you today. Ever be open.
All done, I presume?
Splendid. They were bearers. All three of them. Not slaves waiting upon their master's pleasure, but men waiting to be fed like equals.
Indeed. Equality is the very cornerstone upon which our little community is founded. Beyond these walls, we are scorned as slaves. Speaking only when spoken to, eating only what scraps our masters deign to give us. The first hot meal here is the first many will have known. In the hideaway, we are free. Truly free to speak as we please, when we please, and to eat what and when we desire. More than reason enough to trust in Cid's vision, wouldn't you say? Now, I promised you something for your trouble, did I not? The contents of my strongbox are yours to do with as you will. Thank you, Clive. Do come and visit me again, won't you?
There's a good girl.
That?
The Dominant. The man who killed my brother.
Are you absolutely certain?
I've seen him every night for the past 13 years. Watched as the flames of his Eikon took Joshua.
Look out!
Hit!
I'm here, and so's Togo. Don't worry about us. You've been waiting for this. Go!
Cid! Forgive me.
he go?
Garuda!
control it, Clive! It is you, isn't it, Clive? Stop this! Now! Too nice is your problem. Bloody mess, this. The ghost you've been chasing, it was inside you all along. They'll be damned if I know what that means. Why? Why did you have to listen to him? Benner! This can't be what you wanted, can it?